Dear students, hope everyone is fine and enjoying good health. We have completed Chapter 11, Microbes and Diseases. Today we will discuss exercise. Listen the lesson attentively and note down important points discussed, which will be helpful for you to write answers, dear students. The learning objectives of today's lesson are: to complete exercise questions after revising all main topics, which are useful microbes, harmful microbes, how diseases spread, defenses against diseases. Dear students, in this slide, you can view diagram of sewage works. The diagram represents the main parts of sewage works. The first question is, name three things that are found in sewage. There are many things present in sewage works you can write by yourself, which would be microorganisms, feces, industrial wastes. The next question is, what happened in the settlement tanks? The solid particles, which would be industrial waste, feces, etc., sink to the bottom of the settling tank to form sludge. This later will be removed to make fertilizers. You can add more examples to make your answer more attractive. The next question is, liquid from settlement tanks is sprinkled over stones covered in bacteria. What do these bacteria do? The bacteria is present in liquid, which feed on the remaining waste and decompose it. The effluent is produced is clean and safe to be pumped in rivers and ocean. The next question is, sewage is biodegradable. Explain what this means. Biodegradable are substances which can be decomposed by the action of microorganisms. Sewage mostly contains substances which are biodegradable, like human wastewater from washing, etc. You can add more examples to complete your answer. The next question is, what happens to the clean water when it leaves a sewage work? The treated wastewater is released into local water, where it can be used again for a number of purposes, such as drinking water, irrigating crops, and sustaining aquatic lives. Dear students, the next question is, athlete's foot, blood poisoning, flu, ringworm, smallpox, and whooping cough are diseases caused by microbes. Which of these diseases are caused by bacteria, viruses, fungi? The diseases caused by bacteria are blood poisoning, whooping cough. The diseases caused by virus are flu, smallpox. The diseases caused by fungi are athlete's foot, ringworm. The next question is, what is meant by being immune to disease? Our immune system has a memory. Once you have had a disease, you are usually protected from catching it again. You are immune to that disease. Now question is, suppose you had to go abroad to a country where a deadly disease common. How might a doctor help you avoid catching the disease? Doctor will advise you to take all precautionary measures. He will give you vaccine. It will protect you against disease. And if vaccine is not available, then try to take all precautionary measures suggested by WHO. Dear students, the next question is, explain each of the following is a good way to stop the spread of disease. The first question is, covering your mouth when you cough or sneeze. The answer would be, so that microorganisms didn't spread and harm to others. You can add more explanation. The next question is, cooking food thoroughly. We know that microorganisms are killed at high temperatures, so cooking food thoroughly will remove microbes from food. The next questions are, washing your hands before eating, showering or bathing regularly, never use a towel borrowed from a stranger. You can write answers by yourself. Because we have discussed each and every topic of the chapter in previous lessons, dear students. In this slide you can view a graphic chart in which the diagram shows the 10 groups of infectious diseases that kill most people worldwide, dear students. The first question is, what does infectious means? Infectious diseases are spread by infectious agents like bacteria, virus and fungi. The next question is, roughly what proportion of people are killed by respiratory diseases? You can calculate the proportion from the diagram. The next question is, which is the smallest group of diseases that kill people worldwide? Look at the diagram carefully and write down your answer. The next question is, suggest how whooping cough spreads from person to person. Whooping cough is highly contagious. It spreads when an infected person coughs or sneezes and you breathe it in. Now the next question is, some species of mosquito carry a microbe which causes malaria is uncommon in people living in cold climates. Regions where the climate is ideal for the Anopheles mosquitoes that transmit malaria parasites are more prone to the disease. Anopheles mosquitoes thrive in regions with warm temperatures, humid conditions and high rainfall. That is why malaria is uncommon in people living in cold climates. Now the next question is, suggest which of the diseases shown in the diagram are transmitted by water. Diarrheal diseases are transmitted by water. Because most germs that cause watery diarrhea are spread through contaminated food and water. Often because of unsanitary conditions or practices. The best ways to prevent infections that cause watery diarrhea are drinking clean and filtered water. Dear students, in this slide you can view a diagram of housefly and its different parts which can carry germs. The first question is, explain how each of the features labeled A, B, C and D might assist houseflies to spread diseases. The answer of part A is saliva and regurgitated food deposited by mouth parts, so when fly move place to place and especially on food it can contaminate the food with germs. The answer of part B is hairs can hold germs and dust particles which can be entered in food and they make it unsuitable to use. The answer of part C is the feces spoils the food and spread diseases. The answer of part D is when fly cleans its body the germs and microbes enter the food and contaminates it. The next question is, suggest two precautions that could be taken to prevent food being contaminated by microbes carried by insects such as houseflies. Cover your food. Wash the raw food before eating. Eat freshly cooked food. Dear students, your homework is complete all exercise question in notebook. Listen video lesson carefully. Complete the worksheet provided. Thank you.